Welcome to the online training for the Wisconsin Bumblebee Brigade, a statewide citizen-based monitoring project. This training is divided into multiple parts, all of which are available through this YouTube playlist. This video provides an introduction to bumblebee identification, correctly identifying the species and sex of bumblebees seen either in the field or via your photographs is an important part of the Bumblebee Brigade. But remember, the DNR staff and partners verify the identity of all of the observations you submit, so it is okay to make a mistake. One of the first steps in identifying bumblebees is determining what is and what is not a bumblebee. There are many species that can be confused with bumblebees, including some very good mimics. Robberflies and hoverflies are mimics that are often mistaken for bumblebees because of their similar coloring. There are a few key characteristics that you can use to tell a fly from a bumblebee. Bumblebees have four wings and flies have two. Bumblebees have long, elbowed antennae and flies have short, stubby antennae. Flies have extremely large eyes and fleshy foot pads instead of claws like bumblebees. You will also notice that the color patterns on flies rarely, if ever, exactly match those of our bumblebees. The behavior of flies is also different. You will often see flies perched on leaves, waiting to attack prey. Bumblebees are generally on or in flowers. Carpenter bees are commonly confused with bumblebees, but carpenter bees have shiny, hairless abdomens, unlike bumblebees, which are covered in hair. Carpenter bees also have larger, wider heads proportionally. The pictures below compare a carpenter bee on the left in each picture to a bumblebee on the right. Note the wide head and shiny abdomen on the carpenter bee. Andrenid bees, often called minor or mining bees, can also be confused with bumblebees. Andrenids tend to be smaller, with a shiny abdomen, and they have what is called a scopa, a structure for carrying pollen with many long hairs all along their hind legs instead of a corbicula like a bumblebee. Honeybees also are sometimes confused with bumblebees. Here we have a honeybee on the left and a bumblebee on the right. Honeybees have less hair on their abdomens and have goldish or yellow and black stripes. Bumblebees are much hairier, and most species do not have the alternating stripes down their abdomens. Bombus rufus cinctus, the red-belted bumblebee, can sometimes have slightly similar stripes, but not exactly the same. Honeybees have longer, thinner abdomens, and they have paler, more transparent wings than bumblebees. If you are unsure of what a honeybee looks like, we recommend looking at a few additional pictures online or in a book, as you are likely to encounter a honeybee at some point while surveying for bumblebees. Once you have learned to differentiate bumblebees from other insect species, you will want to know how to identify bumblebees to species and sex. There are a number of key characteristics to consider. Like other insects, the bumblebee body is divided into three parts: the head, thorax, and abdomen. Let's start with the head. For ID, the color of the face and vertex are both key traits. The face is the area around the bee's antennae and eyes, as shown by the arrow and the highlighting motion. The face can be either yellow, black, or intermixed yellow and black. The vertex is at the top of the head, almost like the nape of the neck, as indicated by this arrow. The vertex can be yellow, black, or intermixed yellow and black. After the head comes the thorax, or the middle portion of the bee. Wings and legs are attached to the thorax. The presence or absence of a corbicula, or pollen basket, on the hind legs is important for telling males from females and cuckoos from non-cuckoo bumblebees. We'll talk more about the corbicula shortly. For identification, the most important part of the thorax is the amount and shape of black. The thorax can be completely yellow, yellow with a small black dot, a black band, a large black area, or a black and yellow intermixed patch. The final portion of the bee is the abdomen. The abdomen is divided into segments called terga. These are often abbreviated T1, T2, etc., with T1 being the segment closest to the thorax. The color of the hair on the individual segments on the abdomen is one of the most important ID characteristics for bumblebees. Segments can be yellow, black, reddish-orange, brown, or a combination of colors. The coloring and extent of area colored is extremely crucial in making an identification. Sometimes the exoskeleton of the bee shines through the hair either on or between segments. For instance, in this photograph, you can see some black visible between the segments, here and here. That is not part of the color pattern and can be ignored. Males and females have a different number of abdominal segments. Females have 6 and the last one is pointed. Males have 7 and the last segment is rounded. The Bumblebee Brigade Field Guide, available on the project website, shows the vertex and face colors, thorax pattern, abdominal coloring, and other key traits for the state's most common morphs. The vertex and face color are small and easy to overlook on the field guide, so be sure to look closely. As stated previously, males and females have some structural differences that will help you tell them apart. Females have 6 abdominal segments and the last is a small and pointed. Males have 7 abdominal segments and the last is rounded. Non-cuckoo females have a corbicula on their hind leg. The corbicula is a smooth, wide area where the bee stores pollen. Males and cuckoo females lack a corbicula. Their hind legs do not widen noticeably. In 3 of our species, males have enlarged eyes. This is noted on the Bumblebee Brigade Field Guide. Additionally, males have an extra segment on their antennae, but that characteristic is usually only visible under a microscope. Here is a view of a female with a corbicula on the left versus a male with a narrow leg on the right. Note how the hind leg on the female widens and is very flat and shiny. That is the corbicula where she will store pollen. The male, on the other hand, has a leg that is fairly narrow throughout and doesn't have a large, smooth area. Here is the same photo of the corbicula without any pollen, as well as a photo in the lower left of a bee with a large amount of pollen on her corbicula. The orange blob is the pollen that she will carry back to the nest. It is easy to identify a corbicula when it is loaded with pollen in most cases, but you will also be able to see an empty corbicula given the right views. In this video, we won't go through how to identify all 20 species of Wisconsin's bumblebees. However, we will provide a couple of examples to show you what to look for when making an identification. Here we have 2 images of Bombus griseocollis, the brown-belted bumblebee. Let's go through what characteristics we would look for in these photos to identify the bee as Bombus griseocollis. First, starting with the head, we see that it is all black. Both the vertex and the face are black. The thorax is almost all yellow with a small, distinct black spot. On the abdomen, we see that the first segment, T1, is completely yellow, although there is some black exoskeleton visible through the hair. It can be ignored. On T2, we see that there is a yellowish-brown half-moon shape at the top of the segment and black at the bottom of the segment. On the bee to the right, we can see the half moon shape continues all the way to the edge of the segment, which is key to identifying griseocollis. The remainder of the abdomen is black. The head color, thorax pattern, and abdomen coloration will all be described in whatever identification resources you choose to use, and they all indicate that this is a Bombus griseocollis female. The fact that it is female is also confirmed by the presence of a corbicula, best seen on the bee on the left-hand side. In the bee on the right-hand side, you can also see that the abdomen ends in a pointed sixth segment, characteristic of a female. Let's go through another example. This is Bombus auricomus, the black and gold bumblebee. If you were to see this bee in the field, you would be struck by its large size, as they are one of the biggest of our bumblebees. Even without size, we can identify it based on what we can see in this single photograph. Starting again with the head, we don't have a great view of the face color in this shot, but we do see that the vertex is yellow. You can see some yellow hairs right where my highlighter is pointing. That is key to distinguishing this from another similar bee, Bombus pennsylvanicus. Moving on to the thorax, we can see that there is a very large black patch taking up most of the thorax. Along the bottom edge of the thorax, there is just a little bit of yellow. Such an extensive amount of black narrows it down to just a handful of bumblebee species. Notice that the wings are quite dark, another characteristic of Bombus auricomus. On the abdomen, we see that T1 is almost completely black, with just a little yellow along the bottom edges towards the outside. T2 and T3 appear yellow, and the rest of the abdomen is black. Combined with the head and thorax coloration, we can narrow this down to Bombus auricomus using the Bumblebee Brigade Field Guide or any other identification materials you prefer. Note that this bee is a female. Auricomus males have a different color pattern and also have enlarged eyes. Even without a view of the corbicula or the end of the abdomen, we can determine sex based solely on the color pattern in this case. There are many good resources available to help identify bumblebees. On the project website, go to the Resources tab to find links to them. This includes the Bumblebee Brigade Field Guide, which shows the most common morphs in Wisconsin and is available for download. A more in-depth Bumblebee Brigade resource is the Species Profile pages on the project website, where we provide detailed descriptions and many photographs of each species. We strongly recommend using either Bumblebees of the Eastern United States, which can be purchased as a book or downloaded for free as a PDF, or Bumblebees of North America, which can be purchased online or at many bookstores. Both are excellent resources with detailed identification materials. Other online projects like Bug Guide, Discover Life, Bumblebee Watch, and Bee Spotter also provide identification resources. Check them all out to decide what works best for you. Remember, once you have identified and submitted your observations to the Bumblebee Brigade, we will verify your identifications, so it is okay to make a mistake or not be 100% confident in your ID. If we suggest a new identification for your observation, we will provide feedback to explain why. This concludes the identification portion of the training. If you are new to the project, please be sure to watch all the training videos.